Ciao a tutti amici di Passion for Fun, oggi siamo qui a Romics con un Romics d'Oro, Declan Shalvey, artista irlandese. Thank you, Declan, for accepting our invitation.
Oh, thank you. Grazie mille.
Declan Shalvey is an Irish comics artist and writer. He has worked for Marvel Comics, drawing titles like Moon Knight, Thunderbolts and Deadpool. Tell us about your debut as a comic artist.
Well, I guess my debut at Marvel took a long time. I'm from Ireland and there's not a lot of comics. It's not as part of the culture as, say, even in Europe. So for me to want to draw comics growing up in the west of Ireland, which is more rural, everyone thought I was crazy. So it took years for me to, you know, build a portfolio and go to conventions in England and in America, yes, sir. Yes, sir. And just build, you know, eventually I did some work in the UK, and then eventually it led to work in America for Boom Studios 28 days later. So I went to America when the book was published, okay. So I could meet, you know, I had work published in America, so I could meet editors and artists and writers. And at a convention, I met a writer, Jeff Parker, and he showed my work to his editors at Marvel. And they needed a fill-in on Thunderbolts, which is how I got, that's how I started there. So it was very surreal, because it was Ireland, America, convention, Marvel. It was okay. When I started Thunderbolts, I started in the room I grew up in.
Okay.
So the room I used to draw superheroes in the back of my geography copy school. Okay. That's I was drawing Marvel comics. It was great, but it was amazing. Like, that's all I ever wanted to do, and I couldn't believe I'd achieved it.
What was your first job for them?
Yeah, it was Thunderbolts. It was a two issue fill in. But I didn't know if there would be any more. But once I did the two issues, Marvel were doing something called double shipping at the time, which was there would be two artists on one book, okay. And they would alternate.
Okay.
So at that time they needed another artist, and I had just done the fill-in, so they just kept me on. And I did a Crossbones one shot around that time too. So, like, I didn't have a contract which said I would have more work. It's very much just do your pages, hand it in.
Okay.
You know, but I just kept getting, they kept giving me more work, which was great. And then that moved on to Venom after that, and I kind of worked my way up over the years.
You worked for the Moon Knight comic book. Did you also contribute to the TV series?
No, not really. Generally, most cases, there's no contribution.
Interaction, okay.
You know, the TV seems to take stuff from the comics and use it, but there's no communication. I mean, I found out there was going to be a TV show the same time everybody else did when it popped up on, a friend of mine texted me and he said, "That's great news." I was like, "That's great news. I had a cup of tea. It's like great, I guess." And I looked online and I saw that they had announced it. But I saw that the logo was the same logo we designed for our Moon Knight run, which made me think maybe they'll use it. But I only found out Mr. Knight was going to be in the show, I think, 2 weeks earlier. And I wasn't told, it was because I was doing an illustration job for Marvel Studios and they sent me reference, and I saw the reference and I saw Oscar Isaac in the suit. I was like, but I wasn't officially told it was happening. I just happened to find out. That was very surreal.
Did you watch? Did you like?
Yeah, I liked. I was disappointed that the Mr. Knight character wasn't the same personality as the comics. Visually, it was so cool to see him.
But knowing,
but you know, the character is very clownish and comical. My sister saw it with me, and she was like, "Is he this silly in your comic?"
Really?
Yeah. I was like, "No, he's actually, because you read the comic, he's like really cool. He's intense and interesting and brilliant, like lines." So I was a little disappointed, but at the same time, I understand. They're telling a much larger story, so it's, you know, it doesn't, it's a little
it's
disappointing, but it's TV. Yeah,
it's just TV.
It's another medium. It doesn't change anything. Our comic is still our comic, and I'm, you know, and it is nice to have done something that has kind of fed into popular culture a little. You know, I worked on Venom, and then it became a movie. I worked on Deadpool, and then became a movie. But there were, those were all characters that already existed. I didn't contribute a new Mr. Knight. We designed, and we designed all everything on that. That was more, it came more from me. Whereas the other books, you just, you know, you're the next guy drawing the book. You're not reinventing the character. So to reinvent the character and have that become popular was really, really, it's really cool.
Tell us about your latest work, Old Dog, published in Italy by Salt Press.
Actually, I was doing lots of things at Marvel and Image Comics, and I wanted to make, I realized I hadn't made anything that was like Moon Knight, like punchy and action orientated and done in one storytelling, and I really enjoyed it, and it had been a few years, so I wanted to do something like that. And over the last few years, I've been doing more projects that I've been writing, so I decided I wanted to write and draw and color my own book. And I love espionage stories. I love, you know, documentaries about CIA and MI6, and and I love like Mission Impossible films and things like that. So I just thought I'm gonna make something that would be
adrenaline, action, adrenaline.
Yeah, yeah, like but also a little sci-fi, like okay. like Injection, and okay. you know, it's not James Bond. It's like say Mission Impossible, okay. where you can do weird things too. Okay. You know, because also if you're drawing it, you want it to be visually interesting. So yeah, I just had that idea. And you know, I've a good relationship with Marvel where I can pitch them things, but I'd pitched a few things that hadn't happened, and I just thought I'm just gonna do my own book. And it was a lot of work, and I'm very tired because I did everything other than lettering. And my friend Clayton Coles lettered it, but it has been the most satisfying experience of my career to have an idea and flesh it out and draw it. And you know, work on a story and rewrite it, and then have it published and design. It's just to have the book finished is it's really, really feels great. It's a mix of exhaustion and euphoria. The story is about a guy called Jack Lynch. He's about to retire from the CIA, and some accident happens that gives him powers. But he wakes up 6 or 8 years later and sees that things have changed. The world is different, and he has these ability. So all of a sudden, where he was getting kicked out of the agency, people are desperate to use him now because he's all these, you know, special abilities, even though he's a cantankerous, you know, 60-year-old man. But I wanted to draw Clint Eastwood punching people through walls. Okay. So that's what the book is.
Is it difficult to imagine and then draw a scene?
Yeah, it comes naturally to me because I've worked in superhero comics for so long, and I have a good aptitude for action storytelling. I think I have a good intrinsic instinct for it. But coming up with like set pieces and things like that are difficult sometimes. You want to be a good environment. I find you'll notice every environment is like abandoned and destroyed.
Okay.
I have so many references of abandoned buildings and factories, and because I like drawing broken, busted up things, you know, clean environments. I hate drawing. So if you look through the book, everywhere looks very run down, you know. But as regards to storytelling, no, it just clicks. It clicks in my brain for some reason.
Okay, it's for you.
yeah, pretty much.
What's your favorite character or story you have worked and why?
I mean, I'll say Old Dog because it's all me. Other than that, I mean, I would say Moon Knight. Because after having worked at Marvel for years, working with Warren on Moon Knight, I feel like he unlocked something in me that made my work so much more. He gave me room to be more ambitious and more experimental, and he really pushed me to be a better artist, and I think that book changed me very much so. We worked together on Injection after that, which was more of the same, but I feel that like there was an excitement about working on that book where it was for Marvel, yet we were able to do whatever we wanted. That was huge. But for me, Old Dog is that again for me. So those two would be the best ones. I mean, I've enjoyed most of everything I've worked on, so I have no complaints, but those would be the standouts for sure. I love Daredevil, Wolverine, Spider-Man. I mean, all the stuff I loved as a kid. Yeah, well, I love the street characters a lot.
Okay.
But I mean, as a long fan, Spider-Man, like love, but the characters I like to draw more are the Punisher and Daredevil, and all the kind of moody, because I'm just a moody weirdo now. Okay. So, but that stuff really, it suits my aesthetic.
Okay.
If that makes sense. But yeah, I've always liked Marvel characters more than DC. I love Batman, of course.
Okay.
Batman, but it was more Marvel that I grew up with.
Who's your friends?
Oh, lots. Well, more old dog. I'm starting writing the second arc now, and I'm talking to Marvel about something, writing and drawing something. It's not approved, so may or may not happen. I'm writing a series for another publisher. It's an old property that I loved as a kid, and getting to write that is really cool.
Okay.
And Time Before Time is a series I've been doing at Image Comics. It's like a big time travel crime story. It's like 29 issues. And the last one is out in, I think, December. So that's wrapping that up. And I'm also writing Alien at Marvel Comics. I've just finished my 10th issue. The annual, we just did a silent story annual. This came out this week. And just before I got here, I did covers for Skybound, Marvel, Dynamite, Boom Studios. Yeah, I think I did 7 covers for the last 2 weeks. Plenty, lots of plans. No sleep though.
Okay.
I won't have any sleep. No sleep, no life.
Slagging off. Thank you, Declan, for your time. Ciao, ragazzi. Seguiteci sempre.
Well, thanks to everyone who's come to Romics and who's supporting Salda Press and all the great comics they do. And it's wonderful to see so much comics in every country. And thank you for having me in your beautiful city. I appreciate it.
Okay. Ciao, ragazzi. Ciao, grazie.
Grazie mille.